Kids are pretty amazing. They absorb languages like talkative sponges, while I'm still struggling to nail down English. How do that do they do? Hey, you whippersnappers. Julian here for DNews. I'm just gonna come right out and say it. Kids are dumb. Most of them don't know the first thing about quantum mechanics or brain surgery, but my goodness, do they pick things up quick. What is their secret? Well, you may be tempted to think it's because their brains are growing. I mean, you look at a kid's head and there's just not a lot of brain you can fit in there, so maybe children are generating more brain cells until they become adults. While that might be a small part of it, you were already born with oodles of noodles, though, around 100 billion, about as many brain cells as you're going to have for your whole life. You will add more to your olfactory bulb, prefrontal cortex, cerebellum, and hippocampus. By age 2, though, you only keep making new neurons in your hippocampus, the part of your brain associated with memory and learning. It's possible this neurogenesis is partly responsible for why kids pick up new things so fast. Still, the most significant thing about a child's brain development isn't the number of neurons, it's their organization. A baby is born with very few synapses connecting neurons, but by age 2 or 3, they'll have more than twice as many than they will have as an adult. This period is called exuberant synaptogenesis. Your brain will actually prune back the number of connections because it just doesn't need so many once you're a functioning adult and set in your ways. Before that, though, your brain wires get more tangled up than headphones in your pocket. Your brain as an adult becomes more efficient, with different parts of the brain being connected a long way apart. Children, on the other hand, use neurons that are more clustered together. This is why children are so creative. Their brains are experimenting with different configurations before settling on a structure. So, during these early stages when their brain is so plastic, children absorb everything. Language is a notable example. When a baby hears speech, the neurons in relevant parts of its brain form more synapses. The more they hear speech, the stronger those connections become. It's why their vocabulary quadruples in size between the ages of 1 and 2. I think it's also why they pick up foul language so well, too. You ever swear around a toddler and it's the only word they'll say for the rest of the day? But don't pardon their French, because at early ages, kids pick up new languages accent-free. There are multiple neural pathways, so their brains don't get locked into one pronunciation pattern. After their first year, though, babies lose the ability to distinguish the sounds of foreign languages. Don't get disheartened if you're an adult trying to learn a new language, though. You're still perfectly capable of doing it with time and effort. You're just going to have to accept that you're probably going to have an accent. Speaking multiple languages will help you communicate with much bigger audiences, but you still need to reach them somehow, like, say, through the internet. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name from domain.com. And because you watch DNews, you can get 15% off domain.com names and web hosting by using the code DNews when you check out. There are some pitfalls to avoid when learning a new language, though. Trace helps you out here.
Subjects who talked with the Chinese version felt more comfortable in their speech, but they produced 11% fewer words per minute. They actually became less fluent speakers.
Did you learn a second language as a kid or pick one up as an adult? What was it like for you? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time on DNews.